Hey everyone, Daniel from Twin Bytes with another tutorial for you. This time it's my first video at my new location here, so you might notice a little bit different of a setup. And I'm going to be answering a question from one of my viewers here, Roberta Gallant, if I pronounce that right. And one of the issues is having the username wrong in the user profile. When you browse your Windows Explorer and you look in the C drive under users, it shows a list of the usernames, which may not look exactly the same as the name of your computer username. So there's two different ways you can log into Windows. One of them is through a Microsoft account and one is a local account. Microsoft pushes you to use a Microsoft account, and so that's going to show the first few letters of the email address that you use to sign in. So that's probably what Gala is the first few letters of the email address that you use to sign into your Microsoft account. So you're not going to be able to change that very easily without creating a new user. Even removing that from a Microsoft account and switching it to a local account will still keep the same spelling for the username locally on the computer. So we have to create a new user profile. So rather than using some other utility that you gotta pay for, I'm gonna show you how you can do that for free inside of Windows. If we go on the C drive under users, and then we can see we've got admin is the username I'm using here. There's a default one that's hidden, and there's public, which you're always going to have. So we want to change admin to something else. What you'll want to do is go into your control panel, and under users, user accounts, you can go to manage another account. This is where it's going to show your existing account. We want to go to add a new user account, and it's going to force you to use the new Windows 10 settings. So from here, we've got family and other users. We want to add someone else to this computer. Of course, you can see right off the bat, Microsoft's trying to get you to sign in. So you can't say, I want to use a local account instead. You have to say, I don't have this person's sign-in information. Which isn't exactly true, it's just that you don't want to provide that. So we have to say I don't know it. And then again, they're asking you to create one. Well, I don't want to create a Microsoft account, so click add a user without a Microsoft account. Now that they've finished nagging you about that, you can actually create the new user. So I'm going to create, for this example, Roberta, and then you can create a password. And then as you scroll down, you see it's going to ask you three different secret questions that you need to put in there. So you'll have to create some kind of an answer, and I'm just going to put in some random stuff here because I don't care. As long as you have access to one account and you know what the password is and you know what the recovery information is, then you'll be okay with that. And you can always reset every other account on that computer using your one master account as long as it has administrator privileges. So we'll go ahead and hit next, and it creates the user, but the first thing you have to notice is it says local account. Let's click into there, go to change the account type. Account type is standard. If we click in there, we can change it to administrator, because assuming this is going to replace the account that you already have, this is going to be the only account you have. You're going to want to make sure it has full administrator privileges, or you're going to get locked out of certain features and you'll just be totally screwed and you won't be able to do anything if you don't have an administrator on the computer. So we got that set as administrator. We'll hit OK. And now it says administrator-local account. So we're all good with this. What we'll do now is just close out of here. We want to log out of this account and log in as the new one. So you'll see that it's still defaulting to the same login that we had before, but if you look down in the bottom left, there's our new user. So we'll click on that and we're able to type in the password for this person. It's going to go through the initial welcome messages when you first sign into any new account, so you just need to hang tight for a few minutes and this will finish. It's going to ask you about the security privacy options, so you can always say no to everything or the second option of the two options if you want to have the most privacy. Otherwise, read these carefully and hit accept on each one of these things. Okay, now that we're signed in on the new user, we can go and have a look. We're signed in as that one. And if we go into the C drive under users, we'll see we've still got the admin, but we also have the new user that we just set up. So what we're going to want to do is copy everything from the admin folder into the new user folder, Roberta. That's going to have all your documents, pictures, music, and that, but it's also going to have other settings. There's bound to be some trolls on here that are going to make some comments about you only having to copy a certain user.dat file or a registry setting or something. But the thing is, you need to copy all your files, so your documents, movies, videos, pictures, all that kind of stuff. There are files that need to be copied. Then, separately, there's registry settings, which are stored in a variety of places throughout your computer that get imported in. And then, you have things such as Google Chrome that also would have all your bookmark settings. And that's not going to be stored in the documents and pictures folder. It's going to be in a separate app data folder. So we're going to have a look at all of those things and get that moved over so that we can see. As soon as you go to click on the original user folder, it's going to tell you you don't have permission. So we'll say continue, and it's going to manually try and gain permission to that folder and all of its subfolders, because we did set this user as the local administrator, so they will have control over every other user account on this computer. After a short period of time, depending on how many files you have and the speed of your computer, you'll be able to see all the different folders, except for one very important folder, and that's the app data folder that we do not see. If we were to just copy all this stuff, we're only going to get all the downloads and pictures and videos and your other documents. So we want to get also the settings for Google Chrome and maybe a variety of other programs. What you can do is go to view and say show hidden items, or put a check mark beside hidden items, and there we have the app data folder. So within app data, you can copy everything if you're not sure, or just selectively go in and find a particular program that you want to copy all the settings for. So you'll see Google Chrome has its user data. So what we're going to want to do, let's have a look at Google Chrome first on here. If we have a look at Chrome, it doesn't show our bookmark bar and we can't see anything on here. If we were to go in here and just turn on the bookmark bar for now, it's empty. So I'm going to go and turn it back off, and we'll get out of here. Let's copy this one particular folder, and that was in the old user. Let's go into our new one in the app data. Local Google Chrome, and we're going to paste that folder in here and overwrite all that data. It'll ask you for certain files that already exist. We want to replace them. And that's just for Google Chrome. Let's go into Google Chrome and see what it looks like now. And the bookmark bar is now visible, just like I had in the previous profile, and I've got my one bookmark that I had on there. So you would just need to do the exact same thing for all the different folders. You could go into the old folder like this and just select absolutely everything and just copy that, and we'll go back to users in the new one and paste it. But what you're going to find is there's going to be so much information here that it's going to take a long time and there's going to be a lot of errors. So we need to have administrator privileges to copy some of that. We can say do that for all the current items and continue. And it'll continue calculating, and this can take some time, and then you're going to get some prompts. Some things just can't be copied, so you'll have to skip or say skip all and then let it copy what it can. Check everything afterwards and see what you're missing, and if there's any particular program, maybe it's a game or something that's missing the game files, then you can go into that particular one and copy and paste that folder specifically. And there could be something where a service is running that you need to cancel that, stop that service or stop that program from running first. Then you can copy that folder over and then restart that service or that program. You can see in my case here that this is estimated to take 5.5 hours to copy everything. At least then you'll know that you'll have an exact copy of the other user profile exactly the way it was with your new username exactly how you want it. And that's it for this tutorial. I hope you found it helpful. If you did, give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing for more. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.